Okay, so till now we have seen the nozzle configuration and diverging converging type of nozzle and CD nozzle converging diverging combined. So now we'll look at the isoentropic flow, the mathematical formulations for energy transfer for a nozzle. So this is a common nozzle. We'll look at the diverging type of nozzle. P1, P2, V1, V2 is the pressure and velocities. And we'll assume that the inlet velocity is approximately equal to zero because the velocity at the outlet is very large. That's the purpose. So steady flow energy equation, SFEE, enthalpy, velocity, and heat. It's here for isoentropic, for a nozzle, it's an isoentropic process. So heat transfers are zero. And V1 is approximately zero because V1 is much less than V2. So we have velocity V2 in terms of enthalpy. And if we want enthalpy in terms of kilojoule, so we have taken 10 raised to 3 out and we can enter enthalpy in kilojoules and use this formula for velocity. This is the velocity at the outlet. So we can find the mass flow rate at exit. So that is called as nozzle discharge. And so we have a property relation that is TdS is equal to dH minus VdP. So let's assume a polytropic process. First, we'll assume an isoentropic process, that's why dS is zero. So dH is equal to VdP. And then we'll assume a polytropic process for more specific condition, for more generalized condition. And that is PV raised to N is equal to constant. And when we put N is equal to gamma, we have isoentropic relation. So we can get enthalpy is equal to VdP. We can integrate and we can substitute PV raised to N is equal to constant in this. And get the value of delta S, that is change in the enthalpy. Change in enthalpy is equal to specific work done in that polytropic process. Specific work done because it is specific enthalpy that is divided by mass. So it is per mass flow rate. So, and we also have V is equal to square root of 2 delta H change in enthalpy. And velocity is also known as mass flow rate divided by area. And that is V2 rho 2 is equal to V2 by gamma, that is specific volume. And we have combined the enthalpies and velocity relation to get this relation of m dot upon A2, that is velocity. M dot upon A2 is velocity. So we have just combined those relations and taken P1, V1 outside. And that's the only thing. And this is done to figure out the or get an equation for mass flow rate. So for maximum mass flow rate, we can differentiate it with respect to P2 by P1 ratio. That is for a given P2 and P1, that is a given pressure ratio for the nozzle, that is inlet and outlet pressure. We have P2 by P1, that is pressure ratio is some optimum pressure ratio, and we can get that. So we just need to put the numerator is equal to zero, denominator isn't of use. So we get optimum pressure ratio is equal to 2 by n plus 1 whole raised to n upon n minus 1. That is for maximum mass flow rate through nozzle. And we had earlier a relation between P01 and P star, that is critical properties of pressure, is equal to n plus 1 upon 2. So you must remember this earlier also we have seen critical conditions, critical properties over here we have seen. So the same relations I'm going to use now, but these are with respect to stagnation property and critical property. So there are no actual pressure over here. These are stagnation pressure and critical pressure directly. So mass flow rate is maximum when pressure exit pressure P2 is equal to P star. That is P2 is in the denominator and P1 is in the numerator. That is critical pressure. So mass flow rate is maximum when we have critical pressure at the exit. That is critical pressure means the Mach number at exit is 1. And this is the relation P2 by P1, that is P star by 1 is equal to 2 upon n plus 1 raised to n by n minus 1. N is the polytropic index. So n is equal to gamma is equal to 1.4 for diatomic gases. N is equal to 1.3 for super heated steam. N is equal to 1.135 for dry saturated steam. So let me draw a diagram over here to better explain to you about this. So this is the dome we have. This can be TS diagram, TS curve. So this is the curve for dry saturated steam. Sorry. This is the cow for trisaturated steam. Here is the superheated steam. And one more relation is given, that is N is equal to 1.035 plus 0.1x for saturated mixture, where x is the dryness factor. So that this relation is for the region which is inside the dough, and x is the dryness factor. That is the quality of the mixture. Now we'll see at choking in the next video.